For a scientist, the most important thing is just the thrill of discovery. Most of the days, you're wrong all the time. You do the experiments and it's completely not what you thought, but that is an exciting thing. That's something where you always feel like you're jumping off a cliff into the unknown. I completed both my undergraduate and my PhD here at McGill, and it took me a little longer through undergrad because about halfway through I realized that I wasn't really doing that well in terms of marks, and partly because the classes were so big and you know, you were just like a number, and as I didn't like that, so I decided I had to take off and I left the country, went to India, where I stayed for about a year being a hippie. I wanted to go and explore something very, very different to push myself. When I came back, even though I had spent all of this time reading and having adventures, the thing that still made my heart beat faster was this idea of making discoveries, of learning how things worked. I knew that I could do it, and that my opinion and my vision was as important as anyone else's. My interests here at the Neuro are really at a fundamental cellular level. So I'm trying to understand how the cell works, and more specifically, I work on a part of the cell. It's called the mitochondria. In my case, we made the discovery that we could see mitochondria were doing something they weren't supposed to do. They were taking little bits of themselves and spitting them out in these little packages. We knew nothing about it, except it was a phenomenon we could see. And so I pursued that pretty doggedly. So the question was for me at that point, do I pursue it? Do I go, I didn't see that, and just keep going? Or do I dig into it, right? But to dig into it is risky because you got to write grants, you got to get funding for that. So it took a solid decade before this became a thing that we could really get our hands on and understand and get it out. But I think now the impact of this little observation we made is becoming very, very clear in multiple fields. So I think it's an exciting time now. What I would say to young people who are feeling challenged by science but love it is that all you have to do is ask questions. You have to want to do it. You have to love it. You have to be willing to take the risks. The important thing is that if you are interested and excited about something, if your heart beats faster doing it, you will succeed. I mean, there's no doubt about it, right?